as a perch. It's nailed bait, that's for sure. Look at that. Nailed.
So, eels will drop baits the moment they feel resistance, generally speaking. So I've put these things together. All it is a short section of whip, where I've cut whips backed. It's a telescopic whip attached to a tool clip with a bit of silicon tubing, or a terry clip if you're old school. That's a practice ping pong ball, slightly oversized, bright orange. So a bit of moving out the corner of your eye, you're still going to see it. Then another bit of silicon, bog standard hair clip, and a couple of beads wedged on top with a bit of super glue. The idea is, as you hopefully saw, when a fish pulls, that drops off completely and you're left with a free spool for line to peel off. Don't like to leave eels running too long. The old school theory is that you shouldn't strike until they've stopped, i.e. they'll go in there, they'll grab the bait and then swim off with it to stop other eels from grabbing it. And then once they're in a bit of clear water away from the other eels, that's when they stop to turn the bait in their mouth. That's the old school thought. I've caught plenty of eels striking straight away. That's my preference. If I miss a few, then so be it. At least I know I'm not increasing the chances of a deep hooked fish.
So I'm targeting eels using 3-pound test curve rods, because they, when they swim back, there's even a 4-pound fish will give you a hell of a battle. So 15-pound main line, no messing about really. Relatively long tray, about 1 foot long, and the reason for that is because I'm using stem ledger, which just keeps it all out of the weed, because there's weed on the bottom, and that's free running. Generally speaking, for eels I like a short trace, but because of this stem ledger, it's got a little bit more length to it. Keeping the lobworms on with an elastic band, so we've got 30-pound braid tied to a short braid traced of tieable 20-pound wire and a size 4 barbless hook. That's all that's left. Should have hit it. That'll teach me. Never mind. It's weird. Normally I get more luck with a bit of fish bait than I do worms, but today it's the lobworms that are doing business. So I'll tip off with that segment just to keep the scent going. Get a squeeze. And then last but not least, because it's a barber's hook, you need to get a section of elastic band and just pop it on over the top like that. That should stop it from being pulled off by the fish, we hope. And there you go. People ask why the hell I fish for eels. They're amazing fish. There's been a 95% decrease in eel population, according to scientific research. The reason for that is debated. Quite. Some people say it's because of a liver fluke from the Asian eel that's come over here as a result of farming. Other people say it's because of all the overfishing that's gone over the decades. So glass eels that come into an estuary are worth their weight in gold, and it's literally gang warfare. Selling them on black market, I've got to go, I've got to buy. Missed it. What I managed to look. Oh, bloody hell. What I managed to do. Oh no! All in my shoe. That's the second time my lobworm's been hit since you've gone. And something just nailed it again then, as I've just, that's got to be perched if it's followed it. If it's followed it right in like that, it's got to be perched, hasn't it?
Yeah. Well, that's what they did to my last one anyway. I've just done it again. Gone.
And stuff like that.
Well, they love the prawns, don't they?
Yeah. I'm nearly going to bring some prawns, but still, I'm nicking them out of the fridge.
Can I edit this video? Do you want to be in it? Do you mind being in it? No, what do you want to? Do you mind being in it?
No,
yeah? No. I don't want you to say, oh, you didn't ask permission or anything like that. You want to see the final cut before I put it on?
Yeah.
No, trust me, I've got some very good editing software, so. Yeah. Oh. There you go, Keith, look. See, but it's not. That is put perch all over, isn't it? There you go. Gone. Yeah, for sure. Wicked. I don't think that's a perch either.
I
don't know if this will get it. And try. Where is it, that side of the tongue?
I don't know. He swam away all right, popping his gills out. It was unpleasant, wasn't it? You find with lobworms, you end up getting smaller eels. So I'm going to try that. It's just a roach head. It's a bit stinky, but hopefully it won't take the hook down. You in? Do you want that right hand rod in?
Look at the size of that bugger.
Was that on the lobworm, was it?
Lovely.
Caught on camera. How are you going to sort him out then?
That's how you tie a grin or not.
I normally drop them back in the water and they sort themselves out. What do you normally do? Bucket.
Bucket of water would have done it.
Thought you were swearing for a minute.
But, let's see where the hook is. I think he's going for a swim. Here we go, mate. Quite bait.
It's quite incredible how they can do that, isn't it?
Did you see that?
It's incredible.
He undone himself quicker than those kids could do it.
Yep. Look at that big carp sitting behind him.
Oh,
he's gone now. There he is, just in the shadows.
He's thinking, why is that eel dancing?
That's made a right old mess of that. I might have a very large disgorger if you think that might be more appropriate.
Yeah, the hook's right at the front. I'll get you my forceps. I felt that knocking on there and I thought I'm going to strike straight away.
It's incredible that it's an eel. I mean, perhaps in hindsight today I should have used lobworms for the benefit of the children that wanted to see an eel on the bank rather than just putting big baits out for a specimen.
They've seen the struggling while they're all running away.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Can you pacify little eels, or are they just too wriggly? Can you pacify little eels?
They're too small.
Does it not work with little eels?
I don't think so.
It's the fact that it's metal is probably what's making him go nuts, because the
if I hold him, because I can see the hook in his bottom lip, if I hold him apart, like, see the hook there?
Yep, there's off.
There you go. I'm drawing out now, ain't you?
Couldn't keep up with that one. He's gone. Carp's back though, look. Right in front of us. Didn't even spook. Is him?
Yeah.
Fizzing away. Oh, well done, Keith.
Is it a carp?
Yeah, it's a carp. Eel's an eel.
Well.
That's good, you've got fish on the bank. It's good. But why are these big ones? I can't remember which rod I've got cast out next. It's outrageous, isn't it?
You want a seriously big padded mat, just look in the rubbish skip at Reno, you know, the whole mattress.
Really?
Off the bed.
Why not get any runs? Keith, you can't just catch all the eels, it's not fair.
Eh?
Not fair, is it? It's too much.
Because they smell like one. Look at the state of this wire.
Okay, good luck with that. I just cast out. I didn't even change my bait. I'm so lazy. I've got to snap out of there.
Strong mono. I think as long as you strike quick enough, they've got just a hook in their mouth.
Yeah.
May the force be with you.
I think that's the one. I think that's what I should have done earlier. Quite this misleading shape of this pond, because you'd think the deepest bit's the middle, but it's not, is it? Because it's in the old flooded river, little river valley.
Yeah.
Oh.
Come on, Charlie.
That's
what happened to me on that bigger rail.
I wasn't watching the line, so I don't know whether that was fish knocking it, and that's a take.
Pick your rod up and feel, just hold the line in your left hand and try and feel what's going on. See, it looks like something's happening to your line. See, that's what I did. I left it for a couple of seconds, and when I felt that eel pulling, then I lifted up, but when then it was too late, it went on.
There's nothing here.
I think that hawk kestrel, isn't it? See it?
Yeah, it is a kestrel. Good spot. Dead tree or on the tree to the right of it?
See the tree with all the ivy on it, or in the middle.
Yep.
Go to the right of that, and it's just gone down some branch of swing. Be nice to film it and slow it all down, isn't it?
Yep.
And the little net?
No, I reckon the big net. In fact, you like to bring it over to the other platform.
Can you all right holding him there, Charlie? Because I'm going to get the unhooking stuff.
Okay.
It looks as if it's stripping their chin on that one as well.
Cheers, Keith.
Film.
all on film, which is good. It's onto that bail arm.
Oh, wow.
Shaking the hook, isn't he already? Think? No? No. Wishful thinking.
Right on front. Good.
That's this. How we like it, isn't it?
Keep it nice and simple. Hook's out.
Lovely. What a beautiful looking fish, eh?
That's a beauty, isn't it? Look at that line. That lateral line going down there.
That's the marking I was talking about, just there. You can see from his mouth that he's gone from being a...
Yeah.
An animal that feeds on invertebrates to an animal that feeds on fish.
Come on.
What do you reckon he would weigh?
I'll give you a 3 pound on that one. I'll weigh him for you if you want, while he's nice and still. Do you want me to?
Yeah, if you wouldn't mind taking a picture on my phone as well, that'd be...
Red mark up there.
He's a very still and well-behaved fish, isn't he? I love that black spot. Awesome.
Very well behaved. And we'll roll him in there.
What a beautiful fish. I tell you what, seeing them come up in that clear water, in that, yeah, with that colour, that, yeah, coloration.
I'm gonna weigh him. The creature, she's staying very calm. This scales. We've got a job to hold the scales. This man was so slippery.
Oh, it's not because it's too heavy.
We got three,
3 pounds, 1 ounce. Awesome. Oh, I'm an eel, get me out of here.
Eel is going to be cold.
What a beautiful sight. That's how I wanted to catch eels. Nice one. On the lob one. Well, well, lip hooked on the lob one. Shorter trace as well, in fairness, because I've cut it down from the last one.
Look at my one.